Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me. My name is Alyssa, and in today's video, I thought we could try blocking for the very first time together. I'm almost done with my crocheted cardigan, so I would like to block this piece. It'll be my first time doing it. I don't really have any blocking materials, like boards or anything that you would buy, so I thought it'd be fun to kind of film my process of me trying it for the first time. I do hope it stretches. That's the goal, because I feel like it's a little snug. And then I thought we could also practice crocheting irigurumi pieces together. Hopefully I said that right. I've been practicing doing that, and so I would love to make one with you guys. I think I'm gonna make a little clementine because my boyfriend wanted one. So that's in today's video, so let's get started. Okay, so the piece I've been working on is this Valentine's Day cardigan. I had that. Cut that, but it's just Hello Kitty on the back, and then I'm currently working on the ribbing, so that's the sleeve. So I just have to do the front and make some pockets, but this is what the ribbing is starting to look like. I'm like really excited to be done with this. I did start this in November, so I'm just like, want to be done with it. So when I can wear it, and just so I can just like kind of get it out of my whoops pile. That's the goal. So yeah, I'll leave down below I'll link down below the pattern I was following for this, but I must confess, sorry, I'm just trying to get started on this stitch. I must confess, I kind of messed up the pattern. So on the back, hold on, let me start this stitch, hold on. So on the back, I actually did all single crochets, and then I didn't realize until I started doing the front panels that I was supposed to do half double crochets, so, but it's okay. I think it still came out nice. Show you the back, the best part. Ta-da! There's Hello Kitty. So yeah, so I like it. I do feel like the front could use something, but we'll see. But for now, let's go block it. Okay, wait, I forgot to take a before video.
This is before? Hold on. This is before block. And then we'll do an after.
Oh my god, it was so funny. I should have filmed my parents' reaction. They were like, definitely looks homemade. And I was like, I know. But it's my first cardigan, so it's not perfect, but it's done. It's wearable. But right now I'm in my basement because I want to throw this in the wash. I think I'm just going to do, we will do a delicate cycle with cold water in case the red yarn bleeds. And yeah. Then we'll take it from there. Normally you're supposed to like put it in warm water, in like a tub of warm water, and then like take it out and soak it in a towel. I'm willing to gamble on this and throw in the wash. I mean, I wash my dog sweater. The granny squares came out fine. So I have faith in this one. Okay friends, so while we wait for my sweater to get washed, let's dive into making that clementine I mentioned earlier. I'm just gonna pull up the pattern on my laptop. Me and my boyfriend were scrolling through Ravelry, and he saw a pattern for a clementine and he asked for it. So I said, absolutely, looks super easy, great way for me to practice my skills. And I thought it'd be a fun quick make, because I feel like sometimes you just need to make something small to get that gratification of finishing a project. And so yeah, so let me go into my favorites. Oh, here it is. Let me pull up the picture. Look how cute. Are you kidding me? It's not just the cutest. I don't know if I'll add the eyes. I don't know, sometimes I don't feel like everything needs eyes. But I will put it on a keychain so he can hang it up or put it on like his backpack or something. So let's go get a yarn and let's get started. Ta-da! Okay, so I'm gonna be using Big Twist Value yarn. This is in the shade Varsity Orange. It's gonna be a bright clementine. Then I have this green one. This is also a Big Twist, I just don't know the name. And then I'm gonna be using a 3mm hook. So I'll link down below the pattern that I'm using so you can also make yourself a cute little clementine. Gotta go get my stitch markers. Can I show you the new stitch marker case I got? Look how cute. It's a pillbox that I got from Daiso. And right away when I saw it, I was like, this would be perfect. It just looks like that. Oh, I'm obsessed. Just makes crocheting like more exciting when you have cute things to go with it, you know? You know. How cute. Oh, look how cute the little top is. But I think it's time to go check on my sweater, so we'll come back. Okay, it looks really good. The didn't bleed, so that's exciting. It smells good. So it's pretty dry, so I think I might damp it a little bit before I friends, it's the next day and this is what the sweater looks like. It definitely feels stretched out, like especially in the armholes. It was a little tight when I first tried it on, but now it like fits really comfortably and I love it. I think it would be a really nice thing to wear around the house. I might not wear it out as much, but clearly there's a lot to learn and to improve from this project, so I can't wait to make more. I also want to show you guys my clementine. Ta-da! Oh, it came out so cute. Kind of looks like the pumpkin because of the orange I used, but I think he'll love it. I didn't add the eyes because I don't think everything needs eyes. But yeah, so that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more videos. Subscribe and hit the like button if you enjoyed your time. And if you have any suggestions on what you would like to see, comment down below if you want. Once again, thank you so much and I hope you have a magical day.